All right, so yesterday there was a meeting finally happened, a meeting that had been long in the making, a meeting between the I-League clubs and the president of the All India Football Federation, Mr. Praful Patel. This meeting took place in central Delhi. Mihir was there. Mihir, if you we kick things off, just give us an update about what happened, just the news of the day, in essence.
Well, so the meeting coincidentally lasted for the 90 minutes plus an unusually added extra time, like 6-7 minutes. It lasted around 97, 98 minutes to be precise.
VAR ki wajah
se. Which was surprising. Referee khud ispe VAR tha, by the way.
Oh, we were supposed to do the newsy parts. Anyway, just keep going. Keep going, keep going.
But when the news is funny...
Yeah, I suppose it's all...
Praful Patel apparently had a conference call with IMG Reliance guys earlier in the morning, and then he met the clubs. So what they have proposed right now to the I-League clubs is that the current arrangement stays for another 2 or 3 years. They get time to play around, negotiate with the AFC and also the clubs right now. That's what Praful Patel is expecting, hoping that it will happen. We asked him if what will change in the next 3 years that you know he has been able to do right now already so far. And his explanation was pretty logical. He said that the 5-year lock-in period that FSDL had with the ISL clubs, that would end. And that would give them a little more leverage. Whether it will happen or not is a good issue. But what struck me the most is the change in line of their approach. Like, till now, we were talking about ISL's recognition and ISL being relevant. Now, suddenly, from there, we have moved to I-League getting AFC recognition. So, ye kab change hua bhai? How did that change? Whether AFC will... So, agree, whatever AIFF has to propose, that Praful Patel said isn't sure. And he ended by saying that if AFC does not agree to their proposal, then there will be trouble.
Praful Patel is the AFC's man in FIFA now as well. So, I would assume that whatever he's saying is an educated guess, and he thinks that it is a workable solution. That said, is it also a little bit of putting the ball or sort of finding another avenue to play this out, firing off the shoulders of the AFC? Because when I didn't do the AFC asking a bunch of questions about the league and what's happening in the league and what is AFC's reaction to it, their response was a pretty sort of blunt, we leave what happens in member associations, internal domestic leagues to the member associations. We don't get involved with that kind of stuff.
I mean, it looks like. So it's essentially AIFF president writing to the AFC vice president, right? I mean, both are the same guys. So it's. I mean, I'd be very surprised if Praful Patel does not know what the end result is over here. He obviously is playing his cards well over here. For all you know, I mean, I won't be surprised if a couple of weeks later, AFC rejects AIFF's proposal, and then, you know, AIFF says that देखलो भाई हमने तो कोशिश कर ली. But that's it. So अभी ISL main league बन जाएगी और आप अभी second fiddle रह जाओ. So I won't be surprised if something like that happens either. I haven't spoken to AFC, so that bit that you're saying is pretty interesting of what they have to say. I'm guessing they wouldn't have said anything different as well so far.
Yeah, but I hadn't written to them right now. This was in a larger context because earlier there had been match fixing allegations, for example. Then there were matches that were sort of rescheduled or didn't take place at all. And then the league was still concluded, and we still don't, I don't know whether what the scene is on that game, whether a decision has still been taken or not. So I was just wondering, I had just written to them to ask, ki aap log dekhte hain kya? Aur agar dekhte hain, toh is there some channel of feedback that you have some communication open? And this was the response. So
then it becomes like, if we all of us know,
so I guess
and all of us are speculating in a certain level, then how did he manage, how have the club owners been convinced? What have they been offered?
Well, so the other interesting part was what the club owner said was that they were, there's a 24-hour sort of... Everyone was to give everyone 24 hours and then talk about stuff. I don't know, like you're saying, essentially it's an attempt. I mean, also the bit about it being a minor point who gets the Champions League spot versus who gets the AFC Cup spot. I mean, I know it sounds like a technicality, but only the top league can get the Champions League spot, right?
But again, let's be honest, right? I mean, we talk about Champions League and AFC Cup slot and stuff, but right now we are totally wasting our Champions League slot. I mean, honestly, I don't have much sympathy for I-League clubs as well. They've been messing up for all so many years that it's reached this stage. So, matlab, theek hai, unke liye sympathy yehi hai ki, matlab, ek bada sa...
Fair enough.
So you're saying what?
I was saying it's not... I think some of the... When we have a lot of these conversations, some of it is construed as a criticism of the ISL versus the I-League. I don't know if necessarily that is the fight. I mean, you call the league whatever you want. You do whatever you want with it.
Yeah.
No worries. But just make it an open league and allow like real football clubs to participate in that league.
The question about the AFC Champions League spot and the technicality is exactly what he had said right up, which is that we used to earlier wonder about the relevance of the ISL. Ki ISL ko AFC Cup spot milega ki nahi, ISL ka kya hai? And now the roles have been reversed. Now it's like I-League ko kya spot milega, I-League kya khelenge, that's all it is. Like it's basically a demotion promotion.
Subtly they have hinted at that yesterday.
Exactly.
But the bigger question, I think the whole debate actually is how and why did AIFF sign that agreement? Like, I mean, the name of your show, were they smoking that when the deal was signed?
I think if they were, perhaps they would not have signed the deal.
I don't know. I mean,
to
I
be
guess
honest, so. Entirely. but that, dude, so I want to ask you what has been happening. So this agreement was signed a long time ago, right? And a lot of us were around that time writing the same stories and had also written at length about what this deal means, because you don't need the master rights agreement to understand what IMG Reliance bought from the All India Football Federation. The press release that they sent out on that December 2010 is enough to explain the entire scenario. So have these clubs been up to for 10
so
years
long?
And why have they realized today that this is going to happen?
If I was a club, then it's a fair question. 2016, they kept on saying that I-League is our Premier League and I-League is blah, 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 blah. When actually in 2010, they had signed a document which gave IMG Reliance the right to, effectively, they could have stopped I-League and started their own tournament.
It says
it in as many words.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So that bit I find very deceiving from AIFF's end, and that's the only thing I have sympathy for the I-League clubs. Apart from that, there's nothing else. I'm surprised why I-League clubs did not try harder to find out what the contract clauses were back in 2010. I wonder what took them 9 years to figure that out. And a pretty wacky club owner at that. I mean, I asked the other I-League clubs if they were around the contents of the MRA. And Debashish Datta of Mohun Bagan said that until Ranjit Bajaj leaked the document, and before he put it on Twitter, he shared a copy with us. And that's how we got to know about it.
What happens, I guess, a developing story, Mihir, what happens? I think as things stand, we will have an I-League and an ISL this season as it was last season. Maybe, I don't know, we'll now find out how many clubs will be interested in putting teams into that I-League, given that it is now pretty clear that it will no longer be the premier division for football in India, right?
And if
if you still need a modest investment and want to be associated with football, I-League still remains a lucrative property.
Yeah.
So that should deter people who don't have, say, 30 crores and still be in football.
Right.
The big question is, this decision has been delayed 3 years. So will we do this same episode in 3 years, or will we just release this one again in 3 years?
Timestamp, new timestamp, and we'll do it again.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, new chroma maybe. All right. Mihir, thanks for your time. Yeah, that winds up pretty much this sort of conversation about what's likely to happen with these clubs. Just a quick reminder, we're talking about here clubs now, some of the clubs, three in particular that have been around before the ISL began, Mohun Bagan, East Bengal and Churchill.
I think also before India began?
Before the I-League. Anyway. So the I guess this conversation assumes importance because some of these clubs have very significant fan followings and they're all trying to figure out now what will happen in the future, whether their clubs will continue to exist, whether they'll have what kind of competition they'll have to play in. We'll keep following that story, of course, with reactions from perhaps some of the club owners as they begin to process the situation and figure out what they do next. Thanks for joining in. Back very soon.